இப்பொழுது நாம் இலங்கையில் இருக்கின்றோம். இலங்கையின் மீன்வளத்துறை அமைச்சர் திரு ராஜித சேனரத்னே அவர்கள் நம்மிடையே இருக்கிறார். தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் ஃபார் ஜாயினிங் அஸ் சார். ஐ வாஸ் ஜஸ்ட் டெல்லிங் மை ஆடியன்ஸ் தட் நாட் ஒன் வீக் பாசஸ் இன் இந்தியா வித்வுட் ஹெட்லைன்ஸ் தட் த ஸ்ரீலங்கன் நேவி அட்டாக் த இந்தியன் பிஷர்மென், ஸ்ரீலங்கன் நேவி கன்ஃபிஸ்டிகேட்டட் த போட்ஸ், தே டிட் சம் ஹியூமன் ரைட்ஸ் வயலேஷன் ஆன் த இந்தியன் பிஷர்மென். Why is that so? We both are friendly countries. Government of India calls Sri Lanka a friendly country. When that is the case, is it just for the Sri Lankan Navy to attack the Indian fishermen, carry human rights violations?
Attacking the Tamil Nadu fishermen by the Sri Lankan Navy was denied, not by us, mainly by the Indian Navy Chief and the Director General of the Indian Coast Guard. They have denied all these reports and they have said they have no... and also they have said that the Tamil Nadu fisherman has no right to cross the international maritime border line and come to the Sri Lankan waters.
They are attacked, but by whom are they attacked?
Nobody has attacked. Nobody. Those fishermen has never complained to our authorities that they have been attacked. Only these are the politicians in the Tamil Nadu who spread this story. Not by
so there are reports, sir. In the past 30 years, there have been, you know, killing of 500 to 600 fishermen. They couldn't have been vanished. Our fishermen won't kill our fishermen.
I don't know about the 30 years the records, but in the recent past there have been only one case where the Indian trawler came and banged on the our naval craft.
Recent past, they had some, how many years do you mention?
About 6-7 months back they came and banged on this one, and then there was some fisticuffs and all that. Other than that, there was no incident with the Sri Lankan Navy.
Even in April 2011, there have been, you know, cases of fishermen being killed. These have been reflected in the Indian Parliament as well.
So then why the Indian Navy denies it? Why the Indian Coast Guard denies it?
These have to be proved.
But,
is simple. These have to be proved. These have to go through the process. But by going by a simple logic, who would attack? Our Indian Navy does not attack our Indian fishermen. Our Indian fishermen don't attack each other. So it could be either the Sri Lankan Navy or it could be either the Sri Lankan fishermen. So the allegations are on the Sri Lankan Navy product.
During the wartime, before the 2009, there would have been incidents because nobody could identify who the LTTA, who the Tamilian from North, who the Tamilian from the Tamil Nadu. There had been a war with the sea tigers, because the sea tigers was a very powerful navy the LTT had at the beginning. They were more powerful than the Sri Lankan Navy. So there had been some incidents at that time, but after
you mean
the,
to say the sea tigers killed Tamil fishermen?
No. Well, maybe Navy would have fired, even not knowing whether they are tigers, whether they are our Nadunas, or whether they are Tamil Nadu fishermen.
But aren't they human rights violations?
Pardon?
Aren't they human rights violations without knowing who
Where is the war that without human rights violation? That is in the Jammu Kashmir also there are human rights violations. You can't wage war without violating the human rights.
How do you think this has to be solved? There are still attacks. You say post the war, the situation is fine, but there were attacks, the attacks continuing. And in 2011, people have been killed. What about post the war? Why should fishermen be killed post the war?
Our fishermen come and complain that they have been harassed, they have been assaulted, they have been mistreated in the prison, in the Tamil Nadu prison.
By the Indian Navy?
By the Indian Coast Guard. Now recently they have said that they have been taken over because the Indian Coast Guard and the Navy, we know we are very disciplined. But that those people were arrested by boat where they have Tamil Nadu officers were there. They have said you have killed 600 Tamils in the north and this and that, and they have been harassed and they have been mistreated in the prisons, assaulted and all those cases. But those are the stories that they come and tell us. We don't know. We are not aware. So there are accusations from both sides, but we don't believe. My entire directive to all our fishermen is not to cross the IMDL. We have no right. That is the UN Charter on the International Law of the Sea. We all have signed the document to respect the international maritime borderline. So we have to respect our IMBL as well as the Indian fishermen also have to respect. They can't come to our side and complain that they have been harassed, they have been this and that, all that. because they have no right to enter to us. So the same way that without a visa we cannot enter India, Indians cannot enter here.
That's okay,
here.
But when they do that you arrest, that's an international practice that happens across the globe. But, you know, pouring sugar into the diesel tanks, attacking them, throwing away the fishes, you know, tearing the fish nets, there are allegations of this. You know, this is just not one case, it happens and these allegations come on a day-to-day basis.
But if that is day-to-day basis, you as journalists, you could have gone and checked whether what they say is correct or not. Because we are very well aware that this is a political problem in Tamil Nadu.
We did, sir.
Yeah, most of the Tamil Nadu politicians, big politicians, I know the names, they are the owners of these vessels. And they are the people
who you must be knowing better than me. I don't know.
Everybody knows. Even your Indian the officials of
I have no idea.
They are the owners.
Would
right?
you like to name them?
I don't. It's not correct being a minister that to name, but you can find out very easily who are the owners who are the owners of 30-40 vessels. Of Tamil Nadu. So they are the people who are influencing the government and making an agitation.
It's only political.
That is how it becomes any problem is becomes too important when the politicians are involved.
How do you think this has to be resolved? This happens almost every day. It's so saddening to see the reports of fishermen being killed. How do you think this has to be solved? What is the middle ground?
I totally deny that anybody is being killed. That the Indian government has never complained to us. Indian High Commissioner has never mentioned any killings to me or to the Foreign Ministry or to the government.
The attacks have been brought to you?
No. Because they checked with the Indian Navy, they checked with the Coast Guard, and I don't think that they have.
The Indian government has not brought you a notice about any attacks or alleged attacks?
Sometime back they brought even that we investigated and we said no. And the same way, even the Indian Navy and the Indian Coast Guard, on the same occasion, they also denied.
What do you think is the middle ground? Both our countries claim we are friendly countries. How do you think this has to be resolved?
Yeah, actually, because we are friendly countries, only that we are not reporting this matter. You must remember that the Indian fishermen are not coming individually. They are coming in hundreds and thousands sometimes. Mm-hmm. They start, we have given all the aerial photographs to your Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, through the Indian High Commission. They said that they have handed over to him, and he was shocked to see these photographs. And that time he had referred that to the then Chief Minister, and he was also shocked about how they are like invading army. In hundreds, not in about 400-500, sometimes over 1,000 vessels. They start the journey at 2 p.m., and they come, they do the fisheries here, and all the fishing boats go back, start going back at 4 a.m. in the morning.
At your
so this is very well organized. And they don't come for 3 months for them to grow more fish. So that time they don't come. So this is a very well planned. Now our fishermen, they go one by one here and there, they will be caught. Right, but the Tamil Nadu fishermen, that's a very organized journey that they come every other day, like three days a week. And when they come, not only that, even the Al Jazeera had a very good nice reporting for half an hour this thing, and they showed that they have come only 4 kilometers away from the shore. And not only that, they have attacked our fishermen, they have cut our fishermen's poor fishermen's nets.